name is Silo Bankole, and I'm here anchoring the show, The Amazons, with my good friends, Aisha Falode, and of course, Omasan Buwa. Today we're talking about polygamy, coping with polygamy. Polygamy is as old as creation itself. Looking at it religiously, in Islam, it is allowed for a man to marry up to four wives. Huh. While in Christendom, mention was made back in the days of Abraham of some people that had more than one spouse.
Oh, yeah.
Even in our African traditional religion, we find that we hear of some gods and goddesses that had more than one partner. So it gives us back to the same question. Is it just an African thing for a man to be polygamous, or is polygamy really a way of life for every single male? We're going to be talking about the pros and the cons of polygamy on the show and how it affects the couples, the spouses involved, and of course, the children who didn't plan to be involved in the matter in the first place. So I'm going to be starting with Aisha. Aisha, do you know anything about polygamy? Were you born in a polygamous setting? Did you find yourself in a polygamous setting at any point in time in your life?
Truth be told, I am from a polygamous home.
Okay.
Yes. Was married into polygamy.
Okay.
So I think I know some things about polygamy. Okay. But you see, they say man is a polygamous in nature. It's just an easy excuse and, you know, a rather convenient way to allow the man his indulgences when the woman cannot be said to be polygamous by nature. Remember, not too long ago, there was this rumor that a certain country
had polygamy. Yes, all the men went there.
And all the men got so excited,
yes,
that, you know, they have beautiful women in some country where you can actually marry more than one
legally,
that is legal
by law,
by
yes,
law, uh-huh, and that he was, you know, you will be walking outside of the law if you were a man and you don't marry more than one.
You know, it really, so, really excited me to think of the fact that almost every single man was happy about it.
They were very happy
about
it.
They were very excited.
They said that
about
the lines were so long at the embassy, but it happened out to be a fluke.
And the Aisha women are really beautiful women, too.
Yes, they are.
So what about you? Do you have any experiences with polygamy?
Not directly, but of course, if you're going to talk about being on the other side of men and their non-monogamous ways, yes, but... not directly myself, but I have immediate family who's been, you know, and it's not all kids from, because there's something that was said just now, and the crowd went, oh, not every kid from a polygamous home will tell you they had a bad experience.
Upbringing, yes, that's
you
true.
Know, some yawos got along. Yes. Like, look at all these Oba's wives and
they
stuff.
They all live together, you know, under one big roof.
They wear the same clothes, they, you
but
know.
But that is not, it's not a parameter for judging,
yes,
whether or not the setup itself is perfect. I mean, wearing the same clothes and
coming
it could
outside
be,
and
it could
smiling
just
outside.
Be, you know, like what you call, let's put our differences behind at home. And put up a show outside. Mm-hmm. You know, it could be that. I'm not saying
say
that
yeah.
That is what it is. The topic really is coping with polygamy.
Polygamy.
How do you cope with polygamy?
Yes.
Silo, how do you cope with sharing a man with another
knowingly,
man?
Knowingly.
With another,
you know,
woman?
What I mean.
How do you cope with the time you want to spend with a man?
And it's not your turn.
It's not your turn. How do you cope with the fact that, you know, how do you cope with the fact that you share even to the kitchen, you share
with
it with another woman?
I like to cook for my man. You know,
exactly.
So I can imagine you wanting to list Valentine's.
I mean, it is, how do you cook
to
with
it? Something special, and then it wasn't my turn to cook, and then having to eat something that Omasa cooked for my man.
So if you say polygamy, man is polygamous by nature. The men are also jealous of polygamy by nature. You know, I mean, women are also jealous of polygamy by nature. The men cannot stand their woman being looked at by another man. they get so jealous. You agree with me?
So meanwhile, you have left her unattended.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, we'll talk about so much more on this topic. And we're going to bring some guests in who have first-hand knowledge of this topic, coping with polygamy, after this short timeout. First and foremost, I'd like to invite Dr. Bayode Ogunsanwo. Mr. Ogunsanwo is a charmer. I greeted him and I told him to sit down, but you know, the gentleman that he is, he went across. He is a happy polygamist.
Okay.
He's also... he's also a seasoned educationist. He's a happy polygamist.
And the what
And a
again?
Seasoned educationist.
Okay.
You're welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you very much.
Sir, you're a polygamist or an advocate of polygamy. Why did you decide to adopt polygamy?
It was not intentional.
Okay.
No. Yes, it's a game of chance.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a game of chance.
Okay.
And once it is like that, I have to take it like that.
Just move like that.
Yes, I have to but, move on.
Okay, can you share your actual experience? What happened?
Actually, when I was in university, I had my first child.
Okay.
Since then, I've been living alone as a bachelor.
Okay.
I got married, and my first wife in overseas returned. Okay. That is not marrying another person. So before I know it...
You helped her?
Yes, there are two. And once I got her back, my life was improving.
Okay. Yes.
Okay, so let me understand you. You had a love child when you were in university.
Yes.
Okay. This love child, the mother of your love child, was the one you now married before your wife, who was overseas, returned.
No.
Okay.
I married another person.
Not the one that had.
Not the one that. Yes. So okay. That one returned from overseas, and said that she's not marrying another person
yet. Okay.
Except my very self.
So then you decided
to
marry
her. The family
her.
Intervened.
Okay.
It was very hectic, but I have no choice.
Okay, but by then you had one wife already.
Yes.
One baby mama, like they call it now.
Yeah, yes,
and
yes.
then one returnee wifey.
Yes.
Okay, so all of them, you
yes,
accepted all
they are
of them.
Now two.
It's
okay,
two.
Okay, the baby
no.
mama, he didn't marry the baby mama.
No,
the baby
not.
Mama was the no. place, uncle and
no,
uncle.
No, no,
you
no.
don't understand what I'm saying.
No.
Yeah.
She thinks you have three wives.
No, two wives and a
Before
baby mama.
Before she calls a third wife for you, the two that are watching
no,
will
I,
now
I,
put
I
you
have
in trouble.
Two. Uh-huh. I have two.
Uh-huh.
Then the baby mama returned, so they were two.
Okay.
So 10 years after, I was in love with a widow.
Okay.
So before you know it, we are together. That makes it three.
Oh.
Why are you clapping? Even the women, you are clapping. The only person that is enjoying polygamy is
the man.
Not the women. When the women are fighting one another for one man, you are three. So how do you
three?
How do you cope?
Well, yes,
what's the setup
you know,
like?
Like I said, it's a game of chance.
Yes.
And there are some that maybe God just helped me.
Okay.
One thing is that they should not stay together.
Okay, that's what I want to
They are not staying together.
Okay.
Like one, like in my house now, I have different flats that they are staying. No kitchen together, no parlor together. And if you are a polygamist, you must not be straightforward. Yes, that is the trick.
Like a politician.
Yes, you are a politician. You must not be straightforward. But you must be faithful to the children.
Okay.
Yes, you must
so
be faithful
only the children.
To them. You must.
But is it possible, for instance, they say, is it possible to like people equally?
It's not possible.
Exactly.
That's why I said, if you are a polygamist, you must be a froster. Yes, among your wives. You must be a froster. You must learn how to satisfy them.
So it sounds like a lot of work. And you keep saying it's a game.
Yes.
It's your jokester, you know, it's very ironical, a game, but it's a lot of work.
You see, initially it's a lot of work, but before you know it, you'll be used to it. The most important thing is that in polygamy, money is involved.
Yes. I can imagine.
Money is involved. And once you're able to satisfy them, you have no problem. Maybe, for example now, the father of one passed on, you spend money there. 2 months after, the other one has something to do with their family. And you now kept quiet. There will be problem.
Yeah.
So that's why I said money is involved. Money is involved. And the most important thing is to unite the children. Like my own father, my parents, they were single.
Okay.
That's why I said I got into it by accident.
By chance.
And I still thank God. I'm enjoying it.
And you should be.
I'm enjoying it.
Because he said something now. Are your children, or do you think your children are united?
Yes.
How many do you have?
By the grace of God now, I won't count them. They are 10 minus 1. They are 9.
Okay.
Still. And they're united.
They are, yes. I have some of them in Europe.
Okay.
And across the universities in Nigeria. What I do for one parent's children must happen to the other. That's how
you see,
I do,
listening to you, you are making polygamy so attractive.
Yes.
You know, in the sense that you say you are married to 3 women by chance anyway.
Yes.
And then you are not faithful to all of them. You have to, you know, pretend in some instances or in most cases that you are treating all of them equally when you know that you are not fair to all of them equally. And then now you also think that your children are united. Do you know that women, by nature, are not only conniving, they know when they are at a disadvantage in a setup.
They do.
And once they know that, they tend to also co-opt the children into letting them know how unfair their father is to her situation. And in that case, the children would always tend to go, you know,
towards their mother.
So how do you now know that the children are also not being,
politicians against you?
Yes. You know, as I've said, the main thing there is money. Once you can satisfy the children, like in my house now, they have their apartments, I have mine. When it's time for food, there's no timetable for my food. If you bring, to be there. Like 3 may be there. I may just eat little by little. The children will come near me. We do it together. See, you understand? Mm. And there is no way, even in monogamy too, the children tends to be for the mother than the father. So my duty as a father is to satisfy my children and give them the best, which is education and discipline. And I will never encourage them to go into my own plight, because I said it's a game of chance, and I'm so far so good. God just helped me. It's a risky game. You understand?
So I want to ask him a question now.
Yeah.
Okay.
What is the relationship like without sex? Okay, so
with
I'm thinking,
my wife?
Is it possible to sexually satisfy more than 2 women?
One woman. One.
No, he has 3 now. How does he do it?
Is there an arrangement, a timetable?
There is no timetable.
For sex, I'm talking about this.
For food, for recreation, no timetable. I may be in your room, maybe around 10 o'clock.
Uh-huh.
Till 1 o'clock. I go back to my room, maybe around 5, when the Muslim are calling, they're calling for prayer, I may go to another person's room. You understand? So there's no way you will know. There's no way you will know.
I'd like to take a short break, and when we come back, I'd like to invite someone else to join us in this discussion of coping with polygamy. Don't go anywhere.
Thank you very much.
I was in neck deep into polygamy, you know, born into it, married into it, and then ran from it.
Polygamy became a forbidden fruit, you know, because the truth is that men are not polygamous in nature. They're insatiable in nature.
You see, money is very powerful.
To the Amazons, we've been talking to Mr. Bayode Ogunsanwo. He has been very, very insightful into coping with polygamy, a polygamist himself, a happy polygamist himself, and a seasoned educationist. One thing I got from the last bit before we left was that he's enjoying his plight. He has called it a plight.
No, he can't enjoy it. Are you saying that? He cannot enjoy it. Let me ask this question. Are you saying that your wives don't quarrel? There's no bickering. There's everything is peaceful. There's harmony in your home. How do you?
You see, you can't say it's perfect. I have a patterned way of doing it.
What is the pattern, like, sir?
Number one, the kitchen. They have separate kitchens, separate sitting rooms, separate apartments. They all have vehicles. You see, in polygamy, you have to be straightforward to them. What you do to A must go to B, and maybe C or D.
So there's never been quarrels between your wives, there's never been bickering, there's never...
You see, money is very powerful.
It answers all things.
Are you a rich man, sir? You must be.
No.
It's comfortable.
I'm comfortable.
Okay.
I'm an average man, and I'm contented with what I have, and I share it with them equally.
Okay. At this point... I'd like to invite her.
And in addition, I have control over my territory.
Oh, that is it. You have to.
I have total control.
Like
looking at me,
like
yes, you know the. Yeah, even if I'm not around, there's no way you will misbehave. Because yes, when I come back, you know the consequence. I may tell you.
That,
go
it
and
sounds
report
like
to your
a
family.
School.
It's an educationist.
It's an educationist.
Okay, you say there's consequence for misbehavior.
Yes.
You are talking about your kids or your wife.
Anybody.
Uh-huh. Any of them.
Anybody.
any of them.
I'd like to invite someone else to join this discussion at this point in time. I'd like to invite the Okomiye, Stella Moye, to come and join us.
Stella.
And I salute you, the audience.
Oh,
thank you.
My name is Stella Moye.
Yes.
Beautiful singer indeed.
Yeah.
All right then, Stella, we're talking about coping with polygamy.
Yeah.
Okay, you're a happy polygamist. His name is Mr. Bayode Ogunsanwo. He's been giving us insights. You come from a polygamous setting. Tell us about your own experience.
Well, I don't think there's anything exciting about polygamy. In the olden days, it was okay because our parents wanted more wives, more children
to work
for the
farms.
Sake of farms. And they were really not emotionally attached to these women. Except for, okay, they are my wives, they're there. Okay. But as time went on, polygamy became a forbidden fruit. You know, because the truth is that men are not polygamous in nature. They're insatiable in nature.
Okay. Yes.
It is insatiable.
I agree
you know,
with
because,
you.
Because they find different reasons to name what it is, the game they're playing. You know, they meet a new girl, and it's like, oh, where have you been all my life? Meanwhile, he has one or two already that he has sang the same song to. You know, and there's no way you can love two, three people at the same time. It's impossible. You will like one and love one. You can never love all of them. It's not possible.
Yeah, he admitted that now.
He admitted it.
He admitted it.
But he said so it's a political
what
way
I'm saying is going about the it. Women who go into it yes. are no, also me. As guilty as the men who are the architects.
Yes, they all have different reasons.
Exactly.
Yes.
So what could be the reason for a woman to go into polygamy?
Some of these women... I heard him saying something like, money is powerful,
yes,
blah,
it is.
Blah.
Money
you
is
know.
Power.
So, it is. Sometimes money is part of it. And then sometimes sentiment is part of it. Sometimes out of pity. Maybe the man has spent so much money on her, and everybody is saying, well, you can't go anywhere with this, the way you've gone with this man. And the man also is encouraging her to say, look, what stops you from being
or
my
wife? Or it
could
be sometimes even the woman herself is now desperate.
Yes.
Maybe your biological
thank
clock
you.
Is ticking.
Or they say, in quotes, that they fell in love with a man.
Yeah, because I was giving my own, what do I call it now?
Experience.
My own experience.
Okay.
That I was in neck deep into polygamy.
Okay.
You know, born into it, married into it, and then ran from it. I ran out of it. Because, you see, polygamy... to me, should not be encouraged, should not even be practiced at all. Because it is not only stressful for the man, even for the women who are involved. It is a lot of, a lot of intrigues go into it.
And
it's too many games, too many complications.
Way, yes.
Some people
and
can
if you
really
don't
get
want
fetish.
At all yeah. to compete for the man's heart
yes.
and for the man's attention, the fact that they have different flats,
yes.
Mr. Ogunsanwo, is not a solution. To the fact
the
that
yeah.
three women are sharing one man.
Mm.
And you
yes.
know that,
yes.
you know, relationship is very, you are protective of your relationship.
Yes.
You guard it. You protect it with your all. And if you see another woman also interested in the man you are interested in, you go out of your way.
Yes.
You go out of your way.
And the funniest part is that some of these men are not rich.
You know, that's it.
Some of the men who practice polygamy on this day,
that's what
are not
we were
rich.
Saying.
The
women
are not
such
rich
children.
If I may come in.
They're not rich.
Please.
Yes, let me. There are some men that are fooling themselves. Mm. It's very common. They will have a wife at home.
And a girlfriend.
And another wife outside.
Mistress.
They will set another home for them outside.
Yes.
Their future will be in red with time. If you are with your wife, why can't you be faithful than trying another thing outside? So we that tried it, like I said, it's a game of chance. And it has been like that. And I will never pray for my child to try it. But in my own case, God has been helping me so far, so good. It's a game. It's a brain work, like I said.
Isn't that stressful?
And
isn't it stressful?
Initially, it is. But once you get used to it,
would you do it again, Mr.
Myself?
Yes.
If you could,
like my son in Europe, I did the naming last November, and I announced that will be my last. I announced to the public.
He's answered your question, actually. He said that if he was to come back again,
he wouldn't
try it.
Okay. It's brain work.
Yes. He has answered it.
Which means the answer is that
it's
okay.
Yes.
It's not
yes.
okay.
Yes.
It's not okay.
Once you do something for one, you must do for the other. Like if I want to change their vehicle,
yes.
it must be in the space of 1 month.
All of them?
Yes. If you want to change the furniture in the sitting room, you have to do it at the same time.
But some men are daring. They will change one. They won't change the rest.
Yes.
You see,
all
such
of you
men,
will be bickering and they
such
won't,
men
won't...
will not prosper.
You think so?
Yes, they will not
they
prosper. If you are not straightforward, they will not.
No.
It's a matter of time. An average man must be straightforward.
I'm afraid we have to go on a break right now. We have to go on a break. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You make it sound so easy. Stella, thank you so much. Aisha, thanks for sharing your experience. Omasa, you have done more laughing. We'll take a short break and then when we come back, we'll still be talking about coping with polygamy.
Thank you very much.
I believe personally there is no illegal child.
No,
you only have no illegitimate child, but illegitimate parents actually. So yes. Anybody, whether you are born, wherever you find yourself, whether you are born in wedlock or out of wedlock, you are legitimate and there's a purpose for you,
yes.
And you must accomplish that. That's what I believe.
Mr. Ogunsanwo.
I like the way Aisha said, Ekushe. You welcome back. We're talking about coping with polygamy.
But in talking about polygamy, really, it's not that we are condemning it here. Because some religion actually do, they permit it, they legalize it. And they don't have problem with managing polygamy.
But there's a caveat, you can take care of them.
And love them equally. That's part, loving them equally is the one impossible. That
it's
is
almost
not possible.
Impossible.
There's no way. And in essence, that to me sounds like, it is a caveat, like you can't do it, so don't do it. This is how you should do it if you must. But those conditions you can never meet.
Go ahead and do it
anyway.
Anyway, we have a motivational speaker, a life coach in the house to come and give us a psychological aspect to coping with polygamy. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Ambassador Uche Odims onto the show.
Hi. The ratio of men to women is so, the gap is so
seven to one. I think it's even
So there's a lot of pressure on the on the women to get married, and because of that pressure, really,
we are settling for less.
You just want to you want the pressure to be off. So as a relationship expert, what really do you advise for such people who are in this situation? We don't want to condemn anymore now.
Yes.
We just want to, we want people profess to face
solutions.
The reality and profess solution. How does that woman cope? Who knows you are in love with a man who you hardly see, he doesn't live in the same house with you, there's a tie between you two, which is the child or the children. So how do you, what do you advise for this kind of, for this kind of people in this situation?
Yeah, you're talking about the woman now, right?
Yes.
The truth is this, is that a woman is married, she's married. She has to make the best out of that relationship. That's the truth. And when you're coming into, they say courtship brings out the best, marriage brings out the rest. So when you get into marriage, suddenly, you see something different from what you bargained for.
You see the true color.
The dress now comes out. You just have to trust God. And trust God for the best, because divorce is no good. I don't believe in divorce. God forbid. I don't like divorce. So you just have to keep making it work. But where I always counsel, because constantly I get calls from people and the rest of it, they talk to me, women that have been having all kinds of challenges.
Abuse.
Where I don't advocate is when it gets to, battering the
physical
woman.
Abuse.
Physical violence. Mm-hmm. Abuse. I always tell them, please, pack your load. If you don't have parents, go and find somewhere else
shelter
to stay. Before the man kills you. Before he kills you, believe you me. 2 months later,
move
on.
I don't know if Aisha will agree with me on this one. That is not just physical battering, emotional battering can be worse than physical.
It is.
Yeah, you're actually right, but
yes,
I don't believe.
Be.
I believe that emotional stuff can actually be corrected.
How do you call
it? No, it's a deeper
counseling.
Counseling that, look, I want to see him. I want to see my husband and yet I'm not seeing him. How do you cancel such? I want to spend time with him. He's not here.
Okay, you want to see your husband as saying both of you are husband and wife, not polygamous.
It's a polygamous.
It's polygamy. He's with another woman most of the time. And you
another
are here.
Another woman or with another wife?
Another wife.
So the wife, that person is another woman.
We could go on forever.
If we're talking about that, the woman has to bear it.
Because
that
she knew about it.
Yeah, she knew about it. And
well, we could go on forever.
She was expecting equal sharing of the time.
It's not possible. She has to live with it forever.
So it means, we're trying to run up now.
And that will leave an emotional scar.
Emotional scar.
Yeah,
we're trying to run up now.
Ambassador,
you could go on forever.
We'll continue afterwards.
We'll continue afterwards. But we need to take another short break.
And I think this time around, it'll be a break till next week when we come to my edition of the Amazons. Today, we're talking about coping with polygamy. I was talking about this topic with Aisha Falode and Omasan Buwa. And the last, the motivational ambassador speaker we have here, the life coach, Ambassador Uche Odims, has done a great job breaking it down. He's made us understand that, you know, polygamy is a, I don't know if it's a no-win situation.
No, it is. It is a no-win.
It's that's a no-win situation.
For the woman.
And for the children.
And for the man too.
And for because, the man eventually.
It's a game.
Because we were
it's
trying to game. Understand mental. How Mr. Wuzo like, was coping.
It's a game.
He said it's a plight. His plight. You know, so it's your decision to make. You think about it. Let it play back in your head, you young ones out there, and think about if it's something you'd like to embark on. Take good care of you.